Beasts hiding in the light. Monsters slithering in the dark. I will destroy them all.
The Flame Emperor is our latest Grand Hero Battle Unit from Three Houses. As a masked figure, pretty much any Googling you do about this character will probably instantly spoil their identity to you, so good luck avoiding that. Anywho, the Flame Emperor is coming to us as only our second Grand Hero Battle Army unit. We've had some Tempest Reward armors before, but Flame Emperor will be the first Grand Hero Battle armor since Zephiel all the way back then. They are an Axe Army unit with 50 HP, 40 attack, 25 speed, 37 defense, and 26 resistance. Naturally, as an army unit, they have a lot of base stats. It's been a while since we've had any unit with more than 50 HP too. Flame Emperor also has a great 40 base attack with a solid 37 defense. Their downsides are their low speed and lower res stat, but 26 isn't the worst out there. It's a pretty standard slow armor unit stat line. The Flame Emperor will hit hard, but won't hit often unless you give them some better skills. For their weapon, the Flame Emperor actually has a pretty good inheritable weapon. They introduced the Guard Axe Plus, which is a 14 might axe that inflicts special cooldown charge -1 on the foe per attack during combat. Only highest value applied, does not stack. So interestingly, we have seen this weapon before under a different name. The Guard Axe is the exact same as Halloween Dorcas' Hack-O-Lantern Axe. Lots of people seem to really enjoy that weapon, so Flame Emperor's less candified version should be just as good. The pros of these guard inflicting weapons is that they always work. Guard Axe does not have any conditions tied to it, while many guard inflicting skills do. Things like the actual Guard B skill or Special Fighter have an HP requirement. Skills like Steady Stance 4 only inflict guard during the enemy phase. With the Guard Axe, you don't have to worry about any of that, and being able to inflict guard during the player phase is actually pretty solid too. There are a lot of cooldown reduction enemy phase skills, so the Guard Axe can lessen their effectiveness, and tankier units who may not have the best player phase can at least avoid enemy specials, which will keep them alive. It may not be the best weapon for every single fight, but against enemies that really depend on their special for damage, it can absolutely mess them up. Flame Emperor's pretty good tank stats combined with the Guard Axe is a solid start to their base kit. Their special is Ignis, which is great since that's a lot of extra damage due to their high defense stat. For their A skill, they have Bracing Stance 2, which grants +4 to defense and res when attacked on the enemy phase. More defensive stats is just peachy, and Flame Emperor also has Wary Fighter to cancel out an enemy's follow-up attack. A rather simple armor unit base kit. I don't think we'll ever get one of the fancier fighter skills on these free armors. Altogether, everything does work together. We have a lot of HP with good defense and okay resistance. Add Bracing Stance for more defense and res, plus Wary Fighter can keep faster units in check. To stall the fight even longer, we have the Guard Axe to stop enemy special charging, or at the very least slow them down, and hopefully that buys enough time for Ignis to charge up, and that will probably take someone out. Now, I'm sure most people will give the Flame Emperor some better skills, but at the very least we have a good baseline. If you want to give the Flame Emperor a little bit of investment, a +1 merge will normally add +1 HP and +1 attack. The neutral nature will then add +1 HP, attack, and defense. That brings us to 52 HP, 42 attack, and 38 defense with just a single merge. Pretty good bonuses, and the neutral nature does give 3 useful stat points. I'm glad I don't have to talk about any more Lance Flyers this month. For this video, we'll be slowing things down. Flame Emperor does not have a lot of free-to-play competition. We only have one other free Axe Army unit, which is Halloween Dorcas, and we only have one 3-4 star summonable Axe Armor, and that is Sheena. Sheena's had a pretty insane run, immediately had to compete with the god tier 5 star Hector back at the start of the game, who everyone wished they had. However, as time moved on, Sheena became a very popular unit for players who wanted to hit the higher tiers of Arena. She was an army unit who could be easily summoned, and she could be super tanky after those +10 merges. Thanks to skill inheritance, Sheena could definitely compete. While most class types get better and better low rarity summonable options, or at the very least free units, these are only two non-5 star Axe army units. Not a lot to say here, because you may have noticed that Flame Emperor and Halloween Dorcas are very similar units. They trade 1 point in HP and attack, they have the same speed and defense stats, and Flame Emperor is going to use their 5 PST advantage to get some extra resistance. As we mentioned, Halloween Dorcas also has the Hack-O-Lantern, which is the exact same as the Guard Axe, and his base kit also has a dual stance skill with Wary Fighter. Pretty much a copy and paste job, but without a ton of other free to play options available, I think I'll give this one a pass. The Guard Axe is also a spectacular inheritable weapon. Flame Emperor didn't even have a special weapon in Three Houses, but they at least didn't get a crappy silver weapon. Now, one difference between Dorcas and the Flame Emperor that is worth mentioning is their availability. If you are interested in having a plus 10 Flame Emperor or Halloween Dorcas, you'll need to spend heroic rails. It gets very expensive as you buy more copies from the shop, so getting as many earnable copies is valuable. As a Tempest Reward unit, you only get 2 copies of Dorcas. Unfortunately, it does not seem like Tempest Reward unit reruns are coming back, so unless something major changes, that's all you're going to get. For Flame Emperor, you get 3 copies from the initial Grand Hero Battle Run, and in the future, there's typically a rerun, where you can earn 1 more copy by doing quests. That means 4 free copies. To plus 10 Dorcas, you're going to have to buy 9 more copies, and I believe that it's going to cost you 2700 heroic grails. To plus 10 Flame Emperor, you only need to buy 7 copies if you wait for the rerun, but that does take a little bit of time. That's going to cost you 1750 heroic grails. Buying an 8th and 9th copy of a unit costs almost 1000 heroic grails, which definitely will add up over time. Unless you already have a plus 10 Dorcas or you like him better, which is perfectly a fine reason, then the Flame Emperor is cheaper to invest in. You will need to have a little bit of patience though. For builds, should be pretty obvious, but anything Halloween Dorcas can run easily crosses over to the Flame Emperor. Lots of people used him, so there are plenty of examples out there. For some very basic budget setups, the Flame Emperor will either stall out fights with their superior defenses, or you can use Quick Repulse to whack opponents twice with their high base attack. You could keep pretty much their entire base kit if you want. I would refine the Guard Axe for extra resistance, or defense if you really want. The extra plus 5 HP is also extremely nice since Wary Fighter is super depending on staying somewhat healthy. For assist skills, I like Swap for my tanky units, but I have also enjoyed Pivot because it allows my tanks to get in the front lines. For C skills, any armor emblem buff is fine. You can also steal odd res wave from Mercedes, since I think the Flame Emperor is the type of dude who could give themselves res buffs. Maybe one day we'll have skills that give field buffs if all you do is wait for that turn. As for Sacred Seals, we do have a lot of options. Tech Smoke for even more stalling since Wary Fighter should keep Flame Emperor alive. You can also go for other defensive combat boosts like Close Defense, Warding Stance, or a Bond skill. Brazen skills would also not be that bad since they can help out once Wary Fighter does stop working, or both of them could be active at the same time. Now for other passives, Swollen Shield stops armor effectiveness weapons. Quick Repost is a must if you want the Flame Emperor to KO things in one round of combat. Just don't use Wary Fighter with the Quick Repost seal. For a really cheap offensive build, you can go with the old school Deathblow plus Wary Fighter combo. Essentially, Wary Fighter makes them harder to take down the enemy phase, and then on the player phase, you initiate with more damage to finish the job. This can also be used with a Brave Axe and Threatened Defense for more damage. Now, for the real spicy high investment builds, we're gonna want one of those busted armor only fighter B skills. Bold Fighter, Vengeful Fighter, and Special Fighter just turn these units into monsters. One of the most common setups is Distant Counter with either Vengeful Fighter or Distant Counter with Special Fighter plus Quick Repost. Vengeful Fighter is a stronger Quick Repost skill and grants special cooldown when attacking, perfect for tanking attacks, and Distant Counter opens up the range tanking potential with the ability to take them out. Distant Defense is a common seal for this build. Something that has caught my eye for melee armor units is the new Dual Threatened skills, which are basically variations of Surtur's C skill, but adding something like Threatened Attack and Defense 3 to this enemy phase build, you actually give your army unit some player phase strength. Since armors only move one space, if the enemy tries to bait them to attack them, they're guaranteed to get hit by the Threatened skill. This is very, very bad, and if you want to try to attack them first, then you have to go through Vengeful Fighter with all their defense and res buffs. As long as you don't use Armor March, these new Threatens are pretty great C skills for melee armor tanks. Moving on, we have Special Fighter, which grants extra special cooldown every action and inflicts guard. Probably don't want to use it with the Guard Axe, but with a Slang Axe, you can really spam some specials. Special Fighter is definitely becoming more and more useful because a lot of skill effects can deal with Bold or Vengeful Fighter's follow-up attacks. Even for slow army units, Special Fighter can still be useful due to all that extra special charging, and you can also run with Quick Repose as a seal. Pair this combo with a really defensive A skill like Fortress Defense and Res 3 or the Rearguard Axe from Echidna for tons of enemy phase defense buffs, and you can have a very annoying unit. Additionally, add a healing special like Noontime, Soul or Aether. Before moving on, I just want to mention some other skills. With their very high base HP and the ability to refine a weapon for another plus 5 HP, Flame Emperor can definitely use Panic Ploy. If you want to send them out on their own or want to use Armor March on your team with lots of extra movement, a solo skill could work. Maybe they could use Attack and Defense solo to really mess with physical attackers. It's not listed here, but Odd Follow-Up is another armor skill option. It's basically another Fighter B skill. On odd number turns, you get a follow-up attack and deny an enemy follow-up attack. very potent ability at the cost of consistency and the fact that it's not easy to get since it was only on Duo Hector and who knows when it's coming back. Odd Follow-Up is essentially an Omni Breaker skill that works every other turn. If you're on a budget, a regular Breaker skill could also work, maybe Lance Breaker for dealing with certain crazy Fire Emblem Lords. Last, we got some Bold Fighter builds. Basically, Bold Fighter can turn any slower army unit into a player phase threat because you get a follow-up attack and extra special cooldown with every hit. With 40 base attack, Flame Emperor can hit hard, and with the Guard Axe, you can inflict guard for both phases. That is pretty annoying. Standard full power Bold Fighter build is to just go with full attack with death blow, attack buffs, and some kind of special that will activate on the second attack. If you use the Guard Axe, you go with Bonfire. If you use a Slang Axe, you can instead grab Ignis for even more damage. You can also use Gale Force with Bold Fighter, but highly recommended you have extra movement from Armor March. If you use Gale Force aggressively, you may want attack in defense solo or attack in res solo for a little extra protection, and attack smoke would also help for survivability. Another Bold Fighter setup is to run it with Steady or Warding Breath. This is an annoying mixed phase set since you got Bold Fighter for the player phase and you have the Breath A skill plus Quick Repose for the enemy phase. Combine this with something like the Guard Axe and boy, that would be annoying to deal with without a ranged attacker. This is another set where I think the dual threatens can definitely shine. So should you promote the Flame Emperor to 5 stars? Well, they have a pretty typical slow armored unit statline, tons of HP, attack, and defense with low speed. Flame Emperor's 26 res isn't that bad either and can be patched up. In regards to their base kit, one of the better ones around. Guard Axe is fantastic since specials are so dang powerful in this game, Bracing Stance is a nice defense and res boost, and Worry Fighter is okay for stalling battles. Can definitely replace a lot of things, but at least the base kit works together. Overall, the Flame Emperor is a pretty good Axe army unit for being free. Basically, Halloween Dirk is 2.0, who is quite popular, and having extra resistance is a nice boon too. Flame Emperor is also cheaper to merge up to plus 10 thanks to having more earnable copies with the rerun. While you can give the Flame Emperor tons of premium skills, their Guard Axe should be a serviceable weapon I think most players are going to hold on to. That purple color also looks really good with the black and red color scheme. For those that want a plus 10 Axe arm unit, Sheena has been a long time favorite, but she is the only low rarity option that you can summon for. For nerd players who never got Halloween Darkest or don't want to use Sheena, the Flame Emperor should be a fun unit to use. They will require some better skills to really shine though. That's pretty much all I got to say about our newest masked baddie. I actually really like the Flame Emperor's in-game sprite, I think it looks clean. Currently I just have a ton of Furrow Grail saved up and I'm getting pretty antsy to spend them. We'll see in a couple months, but I might finally use them. Let me know your thoughts on the Flame Emperor. Not an outrageous free unit, pretty standard for an army unit, but I'm gonna take anything that's not a Lance Flyer. Thanks for watching, I'll see you guys soon to talk about the Compile Combat Manual paths.